I'm excited for this video today. I'm giving you my top 5 feature predictions of what we're going to see inside the next version of Blackmagic's ATEM Mini. And I will just say I don't have any inside scoop as to what's definitely going to be included, but I feel like I can make some good educated predictions based on the fact that I've reviewed pretty much every version of the ATEM Mini, and I've been using Blackmagic products for about 10 years now. Starting off then with number 1, and it is the one that I think will be a certainty to be included in the next version of the ATEM Mini, and that is a 4K model. I think we're likely going to see two 4K models, the ATEM Mini Extreme 4K and the ATEM Mini Extreme ISO 4K. I don't think we're going to see a refresh of the ATEM Mini Pro line upgraded to 4K, but who knows, they might also include it in those smaller switches. Now, the reason that I think a 4K ATEM Mini is almost a certainty to come is because of the already existing 4K ecosystem that Blackmagic have. Think about it, they recently brought out the Blackmagic Studio Camera 4K and the 4K Pro, so they've got the 4K cameras sorted that can do 4K output over HDMI. They've also got things like the Ultra Studio 4K for ways of bringing in graphics in 4K. And it also opens up a world of other devices that they can then upgrade to 4K. The recently released HyperDeck Shuttle is an HD only model right now, but it would be very easy for them to upgrade that to a 4K model and keep it in the same form factor. Also, they've already got and developed the technology to be able to encode and broadcast in 4K. They have the existing web presenter 4K, and so they could take that technology and very easily put it into the ATEM Mini 4K model. So I think there's a lot of sort of indicators that 4K is coming to the ATEM Mini line. But having a 4K model doesn't just benefit you for streaming, which brings me on to feature number 2, digital zooms and virtual cameras. The reality is that although some platforms do allow you to live stream in 4K, most people will probably continue to live stream, at least for the next few years, in 1080p. So by having a 4K camera feed into a 4K switcher, but stream in 1080p, it opens up the availability to digitally zoom into an area from that camera, or even create multiple different shots all from that one camera feed, all without losing any resolution or quality on the 1080p stream. And here's how I think it could work really well. You would basically set up your shots beforehand in the ATEM software control, and there'd be a section called, let's say, virtual cameras. And in there, you'd be able to select, okay, I want to use HDMI input number 1, and then I want to set a crop, so it'll crop in 2 times, so it's 1080p resolution from the 4K feed, and then you just select where or what part of the camera or of the feed that you want to crop into. So let's say you cropped a single on person A, single on person B, and then you've got a 2 shot, and those are your 3 virtual cameras that you've set as presets, all from that one HDMI input. And this is where I think it gets interesting, because you need a way to be able to use and recall those virtual cameras very quickly during a show. So I think they could enable in the multi-view for you to actually be able to see those HDMI inputs like we can now, but also those virtual cameras, and you just put them in slots 1, 2, 3, and 4, for example. So in the same way that in the multi-view setup now, we use a drop-down arrow to select what input we want in the multi-view, whether we want to see the streaming status, camera 2, the program output, I think they could also list the virtual shots that we've created as well. They then become tied to the buttons so that you can actually use the buttons to trigger and recall the virtual cameras as well. So as you're hitting button 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're not necessarily cutting between HDMI inputs 1, 2, 3, and 4. You might be cutting between HDMI input 1, but then virtual camera 2, 3, and 4. I think this is the most, in my eyes, the most logical way of doing it. I think it could work really well, but I'd love to know what you think of this idea in the comments below. Do you think it's a good one? Would you use it? Let me know. I'm keen to hear what you guys think. On to prediction number 3, and I think this is probably the one that excites me the most. Network recording, or what I'm going to call for now, record to cloud pod / cloud store. Let me explain what I mean. So currently, the only real way you can record on the ATEM Minis is by plugging in a hard drive to the back of the device itself and recording directly to something like an SSD, for example. But I think in the next version of the ATEM Mini, they're going to enable another way of recording, and that is over the network. Here's my idea. We've already seen that Blackmagic have started putting 10 gigabit Ethernet ports in some of their devices. The new Blackmagic Studio Camera 4K Pro has one. The new Cloud Pods and Cloud Stores have them. some of the newer hyperdecks as well, they're starting to move to 10 gigabit Ethernet port so they can send a lot more data down the network. So if they were to include a 10 gigabit Ethernet port in the ATEM Mini, I think it opens up a world of possibilities for recording. And the one I think they'll go with first is allowing you to record over the network to one of their new cloud devices. So either the Cloud Pod, the Cloud Store Mini, or the larger Cloud Store. And I think if they did this, it actually helps complete the ecosystem even more and gives you some more flexibility. Let me try and explain. So rather than having an SSD plugged into the ATEM Mini that you can't really access and do much with while you're recording, even though there is FTP, you can't really do much with the files while it's recording. If you record over the network to a, let's say, a Cloud Pod with two SSDs plugged in theory, what you could do is record from your ATEM Mini over the network to that Cloud Pod, where then editors who are also on the same network have access to those files while they're recording. And because the ATEM Mini actually records in what's called a growing file format, which means the files can actually be accessed and worked with even while you're recording, in theory, what you could do is have your DaVinci editors accessing and editing the files while you're still live streaming and recording a show. So they can be creating things like highlights packages, which they could then export and give you to put on a hyperdeck that you play out at the end of the live stream, or even packages of action replays or packages for social clips and things like that. And this is something that really excites me because I personally would use this feature a lot, and I know a lot of people that will. And in a world where time is of the essence, you've got to get the edit done as quick as possible. You've got to clip that moment for social media and get it out before someone else does. This is key. Now, I do think the smart move and the right move would be for Blackmagic to just lock this sort of feature down to their own proprietary devices, the Cloud Pod Minis, the Cloud Stores, etc. But in the future, they could also open this up to wider network-attached devices so that you can record directly from your ATEM Mini to your own network-attached storage. And talking of network-attached storage, let me talk to you about today's sponsor, QNAP. QNAP creates a wide variety of network-attached storage devices. A NAS, as they're known in short, is a bit like a giant hard drive that stores all of your data in one safe and central location, but it's connected to your network, so multiple people and devices can access and work from it at the same time, whether that be from home, in your office, or remotely from anywhere in the world. They offer a wide range of features like 10 gigabit Ethernet and Thunderbolt 3 connectivity for blisteringly fast file transfers and a whole host of apps too. Like my personal favorite, the hybrid backup and sync app, which will automatically take care of regularly backing up your data either locally or to the cloud. QNAP's NASs are scalable and flexible. You purchase the size of the NAS you need and then populate it with whatever hard drive sizes you require. Take my QNAP for example. I've got 5 of Western Digital's Red Plus 12 terabyte hard drives that give me a total of 60 terabytes worth of storage, plenty for all my video editing projects. I've also fitted 4 Western Digital SSDs to get even faster read and write speeds thanks to SSD caching. I went with the Western Digital drives as they're optimized and specifically designed for use in a NAS enclosure and are tested for 24/7 use. If you want to find out more about my NAS setup and how it has completely changed the way I work, check out my video linked in the description below. There's also a link to QNAP's website below so you can check out their range of fantastic NASs in more detail. On to prediction number 4. Web overlays built directly into the ATEM Mini. This is something that would be so simple yet so powerful. And what it would allow you to do is add a URL in the ATEM software control for graphic overlays. So it can be used with systems like H2R Graphics from John Barker. I know a lot of people that watch my channel use that. Singular Live, which I use for all of my graphics. And also things like graphic systems like Twitch streamers use, things like Streamlabs and Stream Elements for their alerts and subscriber notifications and things like that. They all use what's called a web URL output. And it's essentially a web page, a transparent web page, which is overlaid on top of the stream. And you could tie that to a physical button on the front of the ATEM Mini, an on-off button that you could just press to turn on and off that graphic overlay layer. And the reason that this particular feature excites me and it's on my wish list is it would allow you to bring graphics into the ATEM Mini without needing an external device or another computer taking up an HDMI input into the ATEM Mini. Let me know in the comments below, by the way, if you would use the web overlay feature, because I think if enough people say that they would in the comments, then who knows, Blackmagic might see that and they might actually consider it as a feature to include in the next version. On to prediction number 5, the final one. And it's one that I personally am excited about because I'm doing a lot of these broadcasts recently, but it's one that I think future-proofs the ATEM Mini line. And that is what I'm calling vertical mode. Now, no matter how much you try and ignore it, there is a rise of vertical live video platforms. Things like TikTok Live, Facebook Live, for example, are all getting bigger and bigger. And with that comes a demand to up the production values of vertical live streams. So I think with a 4K model of the ATEM Mini, Blackmagic could do something incredibly clever and be really one of the first to the market with hardware allowing you to do vertical live streams. So the important thing to remember here, firstly, is that for a vertical live stream, you don't need it in 4K. Very often they ask for them in 720p or 1080p. So there would be a vertical mode that you would enable on the ATEM, and when you do that, it would set the streaming output to 1080p. But here's the important part. This vertical mode would firstly change the multi-view to a more vertical friendly viewing experience. And secondly, it would take those 4K feeds from your camera and the ATEM would automatically do a center vertical crop of the image. So it would discard or not use all of the stuff on the side. And the good thing is, because it's using the 4K feeds, but we're streaming in 1080p, you're again not losing any of the quality and you're not losing any of the resolution. So the ATEM is doing all of the hard work for you. Also, I'd have a feature in there that if you're using Blackmagic cameras and you put your ATEM in vertical mode, it automatically sends frame guidelines to your Blackmagic cameras so you can see exactly what is being shot on the camera monitor as well, or what's in shot and what's being discarded. And so then you're able to stream vertically in 1080p to platforms like TikTok or Facebook Live, for example. But this is where it gets really interesting, and I really hope that they do implement a feature like this. If you are using the ATEM Mini Extreme ISO 4K model, or at least that's what we're calling it because we don't know what it is going to be called, you're obviously bringing your 4K cameras into the 4K switcher, and you've got the ability to record each individual camera ISO. But here's the key part. Even though you're in that vertical mode and you're streaming at 1080p in portrait, all of the camera ISOs would still be recorded in full 4K resolution at 16:9. So they're recorded in landscape. And that opens up a world of flexibility for you in the edit. So when you go and click into that DaVinci timeline file that the ATEM ISO creates, and you open that up, you've got your full timeline in landscape. So it does mean that you can then repurpose the content for non-vertical platforms, for landscape platforms like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, if you want to upload video to Twitter, any site really. And of course, if you wanted to make a square version for Facebook and Instagram, you can do that. You just change the canvas size in DaVinci. And the same if you did want to re-export a high quality portrait version for them maybe uploading to Instagram Reels, you've got that flexibility as well. It's all about giving you the flexibility. And by recording the full ISO files in full 4K, but importantly in landscape, even though you're streaming in portrait, it gives you that flexibility in the edit. So I think this really does sort of complete that ecosystem of recording in 4K on the ATEM, maybe even recording over the network to a cloud pod, and then possibly even at the same time, editors working in DaVinci, but having that flexibility to edit exactly how they need, whether they need to create a landscape file, a portrait file, a square file, whatever. All of the options is available to them. And this really excites me. It really is the dream workflow. By the way, I did a whole video about how to live stream to TikTok, Instagram Live, and Facebook Live vertically. So if you want to learn how to do that, click the I button in the top right-hand corner now. So those are my top 5 predictions of what we're going to see in the next ATEM Mini from Blackmagic. And there was plenty of other things I considered, things like SRT streaming, DaVinci timeline markers, just to name a few. But I would love to know what you think. What things have maybe I missed in this video that you think need to be included in the next version of the ATEM Mini? Or if there's nothing that you can come up with, do you agree with my suggestions? Let me know down in the comments below. I will certainly be reading all of your suggestions and replying to as many of them as possible. And who knows, maybe someone from Blackmagic might be as well. And if there's enough of the same comment and the same suggestion, we might see those featured in the next version. Fingers crossed. If you need help with your setup, my email address is on screen now. You can get in contact with me and we'll set up a one-to-one consulting session. I can take a look at your setup, make some recommendations for changes and improvements that you can make and help help you get your questions answered. And once you've done all that, guys, I will see you on the next video. Oh, and before I go, I did say I would make a prediction of when I think this possible next Blackmagic might come out. And I'm going to put my neck on the line here and say, I don't think it's coming out in 2022. So if you're hanging on in the hope that a new Blackmagic ATEM Mini will be released soon, I probably would say it's coming early 2023. That's my thoughts anyway. I don't know.